sort the pegs out best we can, but sadly, because the gypsies have moved on the car park on the bridge, we are not able to use from peg 21 to 40. So there won't be any problem parking your car there, because you won't be drawn there. But you will be drawn between 1 and 20, so you can go on the Corporation Meadow. So please be careful when you're driving up there, and don't upset the gypsies. We do hope they're leaving very soon. But, yeah, okay.
It's going to be a hard match, because the way I've pegged it, with losing that meadow, I've took a couple of good pegs out. One's the end peg, 52-51, because they just walk all over each qualifying zone. So it's going to be a hard match, so blind me.
We will.
Yes, it's all Lee's fault, not mine. No, but we are very grateful for Lee sorting the pegs out. Very grateful indeed. So 21 to 40, you do not need a car park ticket, but from 1 to 20 you do, and Sue has them over there. We are fishing from 12 till 5. And once again, as I try to do, without them, this wouldn't be happening. So thank you very much to our sponsors. And
okay, that one there, please.
Clive Branson is on peg 65. Yep.
Hey guys, here we are. It's a midweek match. It's a qualifier on Evesham. Don't know whether you actually heard the announcement then by Diane, but they've had to leave a few good pegs out because there's a lot of gypsies parked up in the field. So what they've done, they put all the other pegs in, which I suppose has made it reasonably fair. Lee Gardner has decided which pegs to put in, so he's left out a couple of flyers like 52 and the end peg. Obviously 35 is not in all those top ones, so all the other pegs on the top peg 1 and 2 down to 6, 7, 8, they're going to be the ones to beat today. Now unfortunately I've drawn 65 in the deeps, not a noted peg, never known a match to be won off here. At the moment I'm in the shade, but I got a feeling the sun's going to come round, so I might have to put my umbrella up because it's a baking hot at the moment. We've been experiencing some very hot weather the last few days. This is my first match in a week. I didn't go on the weekend, so I'm back today. As I say, love-hate relationship with Evesham. anyway, it's a match and I'm here, and it's a little mini section to fish for. With a bit of luck, you know, could qualify. But I doubt very much off this peg. really, 63 would have been the one, which is just above the ferry. That's the one. It's 64, and I'm on 65. So, yeah. There you go. Okay, I'll tackle up now and let you know I'm going to sort of attack it today. Well, I won't be attacking it. It'll be very, very gingerly, probably fishing just the hemp and probably down the side for perch, you know. Maybe go for the eels later, down the middle or something. Okay. All right, guys. Not long to go now. Right, just a little bit of a rundown on this this peg. I think I may have had it once before. In fact, if it wasn't this one, it was the one above, and I actually caught a big bream close in on the lily beds a couple of years ago though, you know. But anyway, I'm going to attack that lily beds because I'm looking for big fish today, to be honest. I don't think any small fish will be showing on this peg, although you never know. I will be putting the hemp in. It's about 10-12 foot deep, So I've come off bottom because I've just run it through and I've snagged up a couple of times. So that tells me there's obviously branches in the water on the bottom. So, you know, it dictates the swim. I found a little bit of a clear patch slightly downstream a little bit. So anyway, so I'll be fishing the hemp. I'll be feeding it. I'll give it a go now and again, but I think I'll be concentrating on the inside. Possibly, it's quite deep on the inside as well. It's about 8 foot. So it's just off the lily beds. So I'll probably, I'm going to put some knobs of ground bait in, chop worm, and some maggots, and hopefully it might be the odd perch there, and there might be the odd eel, and hopefully, you never know, tench or a bream, but I'm hoping. But if you don't know until you try, do you? That's the only chance I think I've got in this section, because peg 63 is, you know, that's usually wins the section most of the time. And there's a good angler on there now, Robert McKenzie from Gloucester. He fishes a regular. So, you know, as I say, my section is from the ferry up, which is unusual. Normally it starts from the ferry downwards. And I'm usually in with the numbers below in the 60s, high 60s. Going down to 70, but anyway, as I say, it's nice to be out. A lot of people, I suppose, would love to be in my position and be fishing, so you know, you've got to be grateful for what you got. The sun is starting to come round the tree. I've got a bit of shade. I've got a couple of people looking at me at the moment, a bit of a spectator, you know, bench there, I think. So anyway, just wait for the whistle now. I have set the waggler up because you never know, we might catch a couple little bleak or little chublets on the top, but I doubt it because there's no cover. And I've set up a little feed as well, so, you know, that will be for the eels, for the last sort of resort. So, you never know, there might be some action or there might not be, you just have to see how it goes. I'll try and talk you through it, what I'm doing, and let's fingers crossed anyway. Okay. I just put a couple of balls down by the lilies now, a couple of balls of ground bait. Start feeding the hemp line by there, just a dozen grains at a time. Another little chuck on the waggler in a minute, just in case there's any little bleak. The waggler out now, see what happens. Right, that's enough of that already. Couple of tracks. Let's go down the side. See if there's any perched on it. What I will do, put a worm on first. Thank you.
fucking maggot. A double maggot. Oh, come on. Little roach. Little roach. Come in on that ground, babe. Let's try single maggot then. Yeah, the down bait attracts a little roach and little dace, which I've noticed on you lately. Thank you.
Bugger, I just lost the tench. Bugger. Oh no, yeah, look. Yep. I just foul looked at it, tenched. Slime on the line. And the scales there. Small look. No, I hope that's not my opportunity gone. I knew I should have stayed on the worm with a bigger hook. Oh, what do I do now? Do I go try a worm and see if there's another one there? I'll try a worm and see what happens. Yeah, it was foul luck, that fish. It's a shame, man. If it was in the mouth, I may have had a chance. Thank you. I'll put the umbrella up, it's getting too hot now. Well, what can I say? I've lost that bloody tench, which has obviously cost me. Okay, it's about an hour to go, and it's been a real struggle here today. I gather that everyone struggled a little bit along here. I concentrated a little bit on the inside line, hoping to, you know, see if there's any more tench, but they didn't turn up. And a couple of rough, couple of little sort of dacish fish, and a couple of roach, little skimmer. But generally, it's just been hard. I tried the hemp. I flogged that for a while. No good. Went on the feeder. Didn't get a touch on that either. So. Oop, a little bite then. Yeah, very small fish there, very small. Just getting little bites. I think they're like fry, I think. Just nipping the end. Yeah, small fish like that. A lot of rubbish on the water. Yeah, playing those small fish, look. Thank you. It's not your bigger one. Oh, looks like it's value off. Stuck on the bottom. Look like a bigger fish then. Bloody thing. Well, I should always check the net, see? There's a little one left in there. Well, I've only weighed up in a pound anyway, so I'll back. Yep. Yeah, so there you go. Yeah, it's one of them days today, unfortunately. Just a pound one, I think. 6 pound has won the section up in the other field, which I guess that anyway, so never mind. Thanks for watching. I got a river fest this weekend, so that'll be interesting. I might come back down here on a Saturday, because this is a big money match. And 75 pegs qualify, so I might come Saturday. Okay, see you in the next one.